everybody, it's I Am Quarantined here, and I'm back with another ARC video. My one video titled, How Scientifically Accurate is ARC? 20 Things They Got Wrong, was pretty well received, so I thought, why not make a part 2? So I took a trip to the Natural Science and History Museum and did some more research, and here we are. I realize that some of these facts are a bit nitpicky, but it's all in good fun. ARC doesn't need to be 100% scientifically accurate to be a great game. So, without further ado, let's get into some more facts that ARC got wrong. Let's start with something simple. Humans wouldn't be able to ride on the ichthyosaurus in real life. Ichthys in-game appear small, but they were even smaller in real life. I've attached a photo of me next to a full-grown ichthyosaurus fossil, and you can see it's smaller than me, and I am only 5'1" tall. Basilosaurus in-game are passive creatures, meaning that they won't attack the player or other creatures for getting too close or even for attacking it. However, scientists have concluded that the real-life Basilosaurus was an aggressive killer. Basilosaurus bite marks have been found in the skulls of countless other species, and scientists have even classified the Basilosaurus as an apex predator. Surely the ARC Basilosaurus shouldn't let humans and tames get away with entering its territory and attacking it. Next, I'll talk about probably the most hated creature in ARC, the Cnidaria. If you are unaware of how it's pronounced, the C is actually silent. But what I really want to say about it is that the Cnidaria isn't a specific name for a prehistoric jellyfish. Cnidaria is actually a phylum under the kingdom Animalia, and it contains over 11,000 species of aquatic creatures, including jellyfish, sea sponge, coral, and anemone. The species name listed in-game, Cnidaria omnimorph, didn't even actually exist. Also regarding the Cnidaria, in ARC, when you get close to them, they start to chase you down. However, they shouldn't be able to do this if they're based on real-life jellyfish. Jellyfish are very basic life forms with no eyes, brains, or anything that would allow it to decide where to swim. Jellyfish in real life simply drift with the flow of water until they come in contact with something they can consume. The moss chops in ARC is one of the most difficult passive tames in the game, as it requires a new food item every time it's ready to be fed. It will want pretty much any food item in the game, including berries, raw or cooked meat and fish, standard quality or prime, leech blood, and honey, among other things. In reality, scientists have determined that the moss chops was a herbivore, so it really would have never wanted to eat any animal products. ARC Dodicarus withdraws into its shell whenever it loses 2/3 of its health, and whenever it rolls around. However, scientists say that there's no way that the real-life Dodic could withdraw or curl up, as its shell was fastened at the pelvis and large reserves of fat were stored around the Dodic's shoulders. This leaves no room for it to withdraw into the shell. The coelacanth is probably the most common source of fish meat around the island, but in reality, it is not a good source of food for people. And I did say it is not, because the coelacanth is still around today. Coelacanth meat contains high amounts of oil, urea, wax esters, and other nasty stuff that makes it extremely difficult to digest. This next fact is something that I mentioned in one of my past ARC Dinosaur Review videos, shameless plug. The name Caprosuchus means boar crocodile, which is a reference to its boar-like tusks. In my opinion, ARC doesn't represent this enough in their model of the Capro, but you can see what I mean on real-life specimen. This is interesting too because, more often than not, ARC over-exaggerates features on their dinosaurs and rarely ever under-exaggerates them. In ARC, the Dimorphodon is a formidable aerial opponent, being able to tactfully glide around and strike enemies with great accuracy. However, the real-life Dimorphodon likely could not have done this. its wings are proportionally very short in relation to its surprisingly tanky body, so scientists believe it took to the air as a last resort, much like modern-day chickens and turkeys, and it was more suited to climbing and running. Also regarding the Dimorphodon, the Ark version of the creature is quite small in comparison to its real-life counterpart. In-game, it's able to sit on your shoulder with ease, whereas real-life specimen had an average body length of 3.3 feet and an average wingspan of 4.6 feet. The in-game note pages describing the Gallimimus have an illustration of a skull, but the skull in question is actually that of a Struthiomimus, a smaller relative of the Gallimimus. Following up on that, Ark's model of the Gallimimus clearly has teeth, whereas real-life Gallimimus specimen never did. Parasaurs in-game are strictly bipedal animals, whereas real-life parasaurs were thought to be both bipedal and quadrupedal. Real Parasaurolophus most likely spent the majority of their time on all fours, foraging for food or wandering around. They likely only went on their hind legs when reaching for food up high or sprinting away from predators. Next, I want to talk about Ark's dung beetle. Aside from the fact that giant dung beetles like these never existed, I have a problem with the amount of dung that you can give them at a time. Real-life dung beetles can roll dung 10 times their weight, bury dung 250 times their weight, and pool around 1,000 times their own weight. Seeing as Ark dung beetles have a drag weight of 90, I should at least be able to put 900 weight worth of poop on this thing. The Triceratops, as portrayed by Ark, is not a valid species. Ark labels the species Triceratops styrax, whereas Triceratops horridus and parorsis are the only two to exist in real life. The trike in Ark appears to be a hybrid between the real-life Triceratops and Styracosaurus genera. It gets the three horns from the Triceratops and the horns around the edge of its frill from the Styracosaurus. Much like with the Dilophosaurus, there is no scientific evidence to suggest that the Titanoboa had frills around its neck, that it could spit venom, or that it was venomous at all. Scientists believed it hunted much like modern-day constrictors, by wrapping around and suffocating its prey. Deinonychus in Ark are some of the most beloved mountable tames, but there is no way that a human would be able to ride on them in real life. Real Deinonychus would have been only 2 foot 10 inches at the hip on average and only about 160 pounds. I'll put another comparison picture in here of me next to a Deinonychus recreation. And keep in mind, like I said before, I am only 5'1". I know quite a few of the things Ark got wrong is oversizing many creatures. However, there is one that is a bit undersized in game. The Megaloceros, otherwise known as the Irish elk, is shown to be the size of a standard modern deer in-game. However, real-life specimen were huge, standing on average 6'7" at the shoulders. Back to another size-related fact, there were never, at any point in history, man-sized frogs. While the Beelzebufo in Ark is big enough to be a mountable tame, real-life Beelzebufo grew up to only about 16 inches in length. The last fact I will share with you is about the trilobite. Trilobite is a generic term for an extinct marine arachnomorph arthropod from the class Trilobita, and many orders, genera, and species exist under it. The creature, called a trilobite in-game, seems to be more specifically from the genus Paradoxidus, and since most creatures in Ark are labeled by their genus, it should be called that instead. Thanks for watching to the end of my video! What did you think? Did you learn anything new, or did anything you hear surprise you? Let me know in the comments! Any constructive criticism or new video ideas are welcome as well! Don't forget to follow me on Twitch, Instagram, and Twitter, and of course, YouTube. Thanks again for watching, and until next time, stay deadly, viruses.